Okay, guess I'm just gonna. I don't know if I want to do the map right now. Kind of want to doodle a little. Actually, no. There's a couple of ideas I want to do. Okay, I might have. Let's see, I know I have. Okay, I want to make this kind of a different color. I don't. Okay, so I'm going to be putting. These are going to be cliffs. And I want the cliffs to be a specific color, but I don't know if that's the color I want, if that makes sense. Okay, so. Okay, this is going to be a little bit on the tough side. Simply because. I need to do cliffs. So this whole thing is supposed to be like a cliff right here. So that means that's the top of it. Okay, so that's the top will be more or less flat. Well, not flat, but at least. Yeah, maybe flattish. Okay, let's see. Actually, I don't think we're gonna have. You know what? No. It's not. It will be flattish. It's not gonna have the kind of. It's not gonna have the kind of erosion effects on the like the rest of the like the mountains. Because the idea. Is wait, didn't I have roads? Okay. Okay. Me? I'm always using Clip Studio. Always Clip Studio. There we go. That's a note to myself. But I'm not going. Okay, actually, I need to. I'm gonna go. Refer to some Google Earth images. See, where are I'm gonna actually look at Dover Cliffs in England, because those are just it just happens to be what I remember off the top of my head. Okay, yeah. Yeah, so kind of what I was thinking, because since we're looking from the top. Right, we're the class the cliffs are very vertical, so you're not going to see much things on them. And I was looking stuff up earlier, and with those kinds of vertical cliffs, usually the land right above it is very flat. It's actually kind of, it's often like good arable land for farming, which is exactly what I'm looking at now on Google Maps. Okay, but it's not quite what I want. Look, Gradle. will die when it's Gradle's time, okay? That's not for me to decide, that's for the dice to decide. Okay, so... Actually, yeah. How do I want to do this map here? I'm not sure how literal I want to take this as a satellite photo. Whether that's going to be the color of the roofs of Klaarg or what. Now that I'm starting to do that texture, I really like it, but I don't have that kind of texture up here, so I'm like, ugh. Okay, actually. Alright. Later. Didn't I have... Okay, yeah. That's actually a good thing that I'm looking at this now. Get that color. Need to kind of, I need to make sure that that's kind of an open area. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'm trying to like turn down the music. Right now I'm listening to Squeeze by Sazami. Okay, whatever. She's trying to think if I'm gonna do the same thing I did here, which is okay. Have like a different color for the different vegetation. Haha! Let me see here. Reduce it, 'cause I really want the colors to mix. Trying to really just think, okay, how's this gonna work? So all of this, I think, is going to be like farmland, I think. So right, so it's going to be the city here. Right, so this is all city right here. And then what we're going to do is okay, right, those are going to be the roads coming in. Just yeah, I probably should like draw on the roads here. Nice. I don't know where that road's going. I don't think that road should really go anywhere. I'm gonna have to redo that road, I think, a little. Think maybe do kind of like something vaguely of like of a road in there. Wait. It's just gonna be a vague road, right? It's not. So I guess where it hits the water right there is gonna be like a ferryman. I really should like. Okay, yeah, I guess roads. I don't know where I want that road to go. Yeah, I'm just gonna forget that it's more of a trail rather than a road. Because it's just gonna go to the ferryman right there. Okay, doo-doo-doo. So, okay. Okay, yeah. I know it looks a little really weird to sort of go the long way instead of right across along the beach, but my rationale for that is just simply that it's at least you're gonna be like salt marshes, Just way too muddy. Actually, let's write that down. Salt marshes. And we're gonna do a we'll do like a secret kind of ruined back road back here somewhere. I'm gonna have to redo this road. They don't make very much sense, so. Oh, whoops. Cool. Nice. Okay, so now I need to like. Okay, so. Needs to be. So. So shadows are gonna be on the north end, so everything on the north end shadows, so that shows that there's a mountain here. Nice. I don't know why we have a mountain village here. I just want a mountain village. Wait, isn't there a bit of. Let me see here. Ah, right. That's the water. See here. Okay. You know what? I'm also gonna put like. Okay, so we're gonna. This is what's gonna end up happening right here, so. Probably it's too saturated. Too orange. Make it a little bit yellower. Just to sort of represent, okay, so this is what we're gonna do is that's gonna be the farmland that feeds the village on the mountain there. Kind of wondering how I want to do this. I think. That's probably a little bit too big of a plot. Well, actually, I don't know if it's too big of a plot or not. I'm. Actually, I don't even know what would evil sort of like medieval farms have that kind of geometric look that we're kind of associated with modern farming now? It'd probably look kind of weird, like more irregular in shape. I don't know if that's gonna really look like farmlands or what. You know what? They probably did not look like that simply because this is more of a product of industrial farming techniques, if anything. So they're not gonna have that kind of squarish. Like, you're just not gonna be able to, like, do them that regularly in shape. Not that straight and not that sort of dense. You're gonna get like little bits of like forest and stuff in the middle. Okay, I was supposed to be doing this cliff and I completely lost track of the cliff. Okay. Let me see. Shoot. I really can't decide it. I don't know how flat I want it to be. Actually, I want rolling hills. Anything? What exactly are the erosion and geographical factors that cause rolling hills? Huh. Cool. So I'm looking at formed by mega floods, this place fooled scientists for decades. So this is in Washington, Eastern Washington State. Where is Anna when I need her? Okay, yeah. Oh, this was on Ancient Apocalypse, wasn't it? Actually, I'm seeing a good shot that I would like. Right, so it's one of the other things is. Right, so. See, so usually there's a little bit of layering on the cliffs. I notice on that's actually part of the formation of them sometimes for some kinds. Wait, I don't. Do I want? No, I want this to flatten out a little. Okay, yeah. It's gonna be kind of weird because this is supposed to be flatter rather than like an actual cliff face, so I'm not exactly sure. Let's see here. Right there. Ooh. Does that make sense? I don't know. So, right, so this is cliff faces coming up and then sloping, a gentle slope going downward. That's too dark. Let me see. Okay, oops. I see, I don't think we would actually have that really deep dig into it like that. See, that's the other thing. This is where Dermal Runner Farm are supposed to be, so I'm pretty sure. Let me pull up my map of Dermal Runner Farm. Let me see here. Okay, yeah. I'm trying to think, where are they on these things? Okay, I think. So I put like a really small one on the original one because I'm just kind of trying to figure stuff out. So if I'm doing this, right, like, so this is supposed to be the. Okay, way out over there. Heldar, the spike. Because I want it to be a mountain, is what it is. Okay, yeah, so this road right here. So you're gonna have. Yeah, okay, wait. Okay, so yeah. This road right here, this road is what's actually becoming here? Wait a minute. Okay, so one, two roads. One, two. Oh, I didn't put it in here. There's no road in here. There's supposed to be another road right here. And it's supposed to be right here underneath that juncture. Did I do that right? No. If I'm gonna be consistent, it's like about here. Okay. Let me see. Okay. I'm gonna have to put maybe these streams back in. Okay. This is gonna be all the dermal farm right here, the bee farm. I am thinking this a little bit too naturalistically. This here is supposed to be a big rock formation, similar to let's say a Half Dome in Yosemite, but I'm like thinking too much of making actual like erosion forces like for cliffs. So this is really flat now. So I'm just gonna like. Be whatever and just fake it and just put in like a mountain in there. Just trying to decide how I want to do this spike here. Ugh, gotta make it greener. Okay, now I'm gonna have to do the other way. Yeah, I'm gonna make this even bigger. Nice. Okay, there we go. I don't know how kind of like weird and fantastical I want to make that actual spike be. Okay, yeah, let's label it so that I remember. Heldar the Spike. I really don't know if this makes any sense because this is supposed to be, I guess. Right, so. I guess this is just for me, kind of my own enjoyment here. So right, we have a mountain ridge coming down this way, another one right here, and another one right here. So this is a whole like valley in here. So I guess all the erosion and sediment coming down basically makes a flat plain here. And water erosion kind of shoots up this. Well, I don't know if water erosion is so much cutting into it as well as the ground coming up, right? Ground coming up, so water then fills in. Or the other way, like glacier here cuts through one of the two. Same thing here. Cut through, right? So it's just so that it's just this is going to be a really high elevation right here, and it's going to be really low, like swamps. I don't know if that makes any sense. To basically have, I guess this is going to end up being like a delta. All the sediment right here from the rivers are going to come and dump it into here to make the sand. So this is going to be really low lying, very easily flooded. So, something like that. But again, that level of detail is entirely necessary. Ho-ho-ho. Just trying to think, okay. See here, Still kind of trying to figure out where I want to put the mountains and stuff. I'm just trying to think. Would the roads? Okay, this is gonna be a secret road, right? So, okay, nobody knows about it. No, let's not do mountain right there. At that point, I think the mountains is already sort of kind of weakened out. Okay, I don't want to. I don't know what I want to do here, huh? I'm just really wondering, okay. Not everything's so. I think my guess would be that modern urbanization structures of populations kind of warp how these maps are done, expecting populations to cluster around urban centers, but I get the feeling that's not how it was done in like medieval times. So villages, yeah, so what, family units, tribes, I don't know, like it's like how are you gonna spread out people, right? So we don't have industrial farming techniques, so that means the like the caloric density of an area just isn't as dense. So I'm guessing that puts constraints on population, so I'm guessing people are more spread out, but I don't know. I'm just kind of doing whatever because I'm trying to think, like, do I want? Okay, yeah, actually, I want a pen though. No, really small. I don't know if I. Let me see, trying to make like a. I want a delta. Yeah. Let me see here. I'm like, I'm very meditative to put the rivers in. Let me see here. I really, really focus on the Tang Rivers. Probably way too big. Okay, good. The width of it is also sort of it is not just how much water, but like how shallow it is. That's what I'm sort of planning out, is that up here it's a thinner stream, it's a deeper stream, so it's narrower. Here it's a wider, shallower river. It's just, I don't know if that makes sense for geography or geographical purposes, but whatever. Ho ho. Nice. See, you know, another thing, a big river here. Not everything's a. Wait, actually, not everything's a delta. Everything should be a delta, though. Okay, let me see here. Shoot. You know, actually, there was a thing that I wanted to do. Okay, since I'm doing that mountain, let me see, flip that over the other way. I really shouldn't like take the time to paint the. Yeah, okay. Let me see. You're gonna see me on I name my files. I mean, you can see that at the top of the screen anyway, but okay. And can I put an apostrophe in the file name? I don't remember. Okay, I'm gonna take some colors in here. I need the resolution that high? Probably not. 6,000, but 8,000 by 6,000 is quite a bit. I want like a quick kind of doodle here to think about how I want to make this. I want to make this a mountain. Ooh, flying saucers right now. Whoops, that's a spoiler. Get rid of some of that. Get rid of that, like, sharp line. Take down that brush density. Really need to think about the horizon. Ouch. That's too darker. Well, actually, you know, think about this for a second. Like, the water is going to be deep, so it should be darker. Like, just fill that in. Just fill that in. Don't brush it in. Oops. I don't think I want it to be that. That's a gentle of a slope. I want something bigger. I don't know if I want it to actually literally be a spike like this. I do want it to be ominous, though. Okay, so let's... Okay, so... Presumably we're looking north on this shot. Oops. Right, north. Right down that way. Actually, no. We want to look down that a little bit, so... So we're going to do that a little. Okay, the thing is, okay, so let me see, we can close that one down. Close that down too. So I'm trying to think, okay, so we're looking north. We're looking northeast. So the sun is either to the right, behind us, or to the left. We'll do it sort of behind us. Or a little bit to right over our right shoulder. So we're going to make this darker shading, right? That's too dark. Okay, so down into this mouth here. This is able to go long like that, but it's because it's flat, you have to be able to show a tremendous amount of like texture as you go back. So, right. So we have to like kind of like change and like the strokes. and the colors, right? So that it kind of shows that you're going back and back and back and back. But f it has to change like more quickly. Probably have to make it gray or. Because what it is it's the. It's a bit of the Doppler effect for one, and also, bit of the Doppler effect and water vapor. Okay, I should make the brush stroke like smaller. Right, so clouds further in the distance, right? Me thinking, I don't know if those clouds are kind of I'm like really sort of obsessing over the clouds. I don't need the clouds. Oops, I'm on the wrong one. Yeah, it's not a volcano. Nice. Okay. Clouds. This is way too saturated, I think, but it gives an idea of what I want. Oh, I'm on the cloud layer. Darn. Course. Okay, yeah. Okay. Would you be able to see these mountains way in the back? Maybe. I doubt it. Well, yeah, I kind of need like a different tone just so you can tell that there's some mountains over there in the distance. Do. Okay. So the let me see how you do this, I think. So what we're gonna do is okay. Klaarg, Goblin Town. It's behind there. Huh. Trying to think, what's an opposing looking mountain? I'm trying to think of, I'm looking at pictures like a, I'm trying to think like Sharp Mountain. Probably wouldn't look exactly the way I'm thinking of, like, maybe. I want it, so I'll get it. I get what I want. I'm trying to figure out where is this photo I'm looking at. Huh. The problem is if it's this steep that I'm what I'm looking at, it's gonna be like so hard to like put vegetation on. Actually, you know what, that might be kind of a bonus. Let me see. Yeah, I'm really gonna have to like do a little bit of scenery painting to kind of figure out how I want to do this. Okay, ooh, I should take all the hardness down and stuff. Let me see here. I'm really getting into the details. I'm trying to think of, okay, is this? I don't know if this is the overall silhouette that I want. Let's do fantastical element. Like, we're gonna say forget to do the kind of geological elements that I'm trying to put in, like naturalistic geological elements. Say screw it. Just do. You're just gonna forget it, and then whatever I want right now. I don't like that shape. But I wanted to make it look more jagged. I think that's cool. Still looks naturalistic, but it's kind of weird looking. Like, what's with this mountain here? Yeah, we're gonna put something like also kind of freaky. I want like one last really freaky element, like just completely uncanny. It just. You just sort of like. When people look at it, like, wait, what is that? Why like that? No. No, like that. I'm being quiet because I don't want to explain what this is. I do not want to explain what this is. I like to zoom out and zoom in. Yeah, okay. It's weird, like zooming in. Enhance. Yeah, I'm really digging this, Okay, but now I'm gonna like, oh, I have to completely redo what I was thinking right here. Whoops. If I'm trying to think, if I pull this out. Okay, yeah, this is. Gonna take this one. Unflatten. See, just so I can see both of them on the screen like that. Right, so this is gonna be moving toward the end here. Okay, wait. Oops. Okay, yeah, I'm trying to get match this right here. I'm guessing it's gonna be sloping down a little and then eat into it a little. Trying to think, okay, wait. I guess we'll cast like a literal shadow here. See, kind of, because it's going to be hitting it kind of obliquely. Oh, whoops. Nope, wrong brush. Okay. Cool. I really like that. I'm just kind of like messing around and I make myself a nice little mountain here. You know? Okay, so. I do want the. Gonna put that behind there so we can look at it here. Okay, so I think. Trying to decide if how big I want them cliffs to be. I'm very sorry that you can hear me like suck on my lips and suck on my teeth. So the reason, okay, so there is a little bit of stick that off. Take off after each other, okay. So again, like the C thing, we have to. Actually, let's change brush size, do it this way. Right, 'cause so it's that the texture, right, that I'm doing right here has to get smaller and thinner. Oops. As you get closer and closer to the shore. So I mean by this distance, right, it has to be basically, yeah, I'm like just like speckles, like really like just little dots. Oops. Oh yeah, whoops. I really have to like study, do a little bit of studies of what of water surface to get this kind of look really nice. There's probably some layering that I need to be doing, but I don't know how to do it right now. Oops. Do not cut that layer. Just trying to break that up a little. Probably should use a different, different brush. Actually, here, actually, that's what I need to be doing. I need to do the reflection. Ho ho, let's do reflections. Do this way, this way. Yeah. Let's do reflection. I'm just kind of like whatever right now. 'Cause I just want like the vagaries of a reflection in the water right now. I could just flip the image, but that's actually technically not how the reflection works. There's a little bit like depending on how you're like sort of situated, the because at the way I have it now, I don't. So I gotta put this. Right, like if you're standing like this, or you have the mountain, let's actually change the mountain here. Right, so if you're looking at it like this, with your eyes like this, and you flip it, you're not, right, you're actually at a slightly different angle. Right, so this distance here now becomes when you're flipped the other way, because you're below the horizon. It's basically like if you were to do, okay, like this now. So now you're actually looking more up at it. So if you do another, If you exaggerated more, the horizon like that, let's say you're looking at it like this, right? That distance, flip it back over, right? That means on the reflection side, you'd end up looking at it like that. And so it actually shifts it. It actually shifts the image slightly. So I can't just copy paste it like that. It's really easy to do it that way, but that's technically not what how it works. I'm just kind of going through. Actually, I mean, if I'm doing this really accurate, I really should have done like another, right, reflection on water. I thought I was supposed to be doing a map. Let me see. Do. Yeah, something like that. I'm so emo. My favorite song on Taylor Swift's 1989 is Breathe. Or Clean, sorry. Clean. So emo. Nice. Kind of don't want to touch it anymore because it's such a good gesture. Just by itself is such a good like illustrative gesture of what this is supposed to look like, and it really gets the point across, so I'm pretty happy with that. I'll just refine it just a little bit more just to be consistent with the map. Oops. Yeah, I'm gonna have to redo that, like. Okay, yeah, we're gonna keep going like that with a higher elevation. Beep, 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 beep. I wonder if this location exists in New Zealand. I think, okay, in China. Trying to pull up another music list for me to listen to. I think, wait. Okay, yeah. So that's gonna be the edge right there. Make that like the horizon. Or even with the horizon, so that doesn't get in the way. Let me see. Da, 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 da. Okay. So that's gonna be like, so it's gonna have the kind of a rolling hill look to it right there. But then, like, have a bit of a cliff face right there. Okay, probably add a little bit more texture. It, like, this is where I need, because it's further and back, right? To show that perspective, I need smaller brush strokes, right? Because it's smaller and it's further into the distance. So, right. So the objects have to be smaller. I'm going to repaint this on the map, definitely. Definitely repaint this on the map. I really need the, like, the green to kind of come up closer, right? Because it's grasses or plants are gonna grow wherever they can. It's basically just the vertical slope is what's gonna stop them. So all of this rock needs to sort of seem like it kind of like bursts out of the vegetation. Right, the forest around it is trying to swallow it. Oops, that's way too strong. Okay, great. I'm just kind of doing like a halo. Oh, I know what I got. I know there's something I know I need to put on there. Cool. Okay, yeah. The thing that I wanted to put in here. See, we're gonna up the brush density, hardness. We are putting a pteranodon in here. No, I'm like a brighter red, saturated red. I want this, and the wings need to be translucent, so we're gonna like. Might be too much. I don't know how the feet's supposed to look like. I mean, like how the feet are supposed to be while it's flying. I know I feel like it's a dumb joke, but whatever. That's my dinosaur, so we're gonna put a make sure you label your and your labels to Ranadon. Is that how you spell it? I don't think I s okay, it's a two O's, not two A's, two O's. Oh wait, actually there's another good thing is that it's this is a North American dinosaur, sort of. That'll match the T-Rex that I had in the other previous session. Probably like too bright, honestly. I just need to like break that up just so you don't have the brushstroke look. That's why I kind of like the second stroke, right? The stroke to put down the color and then the second stroke to eat into that that's first stroke. I think really makes it look real nice. mean, I think it's too saturated. I'm just making like texture, like I want that kind of cragged, ragged, well, craggly, I don't know, broken up look, rocky. Shiny and chrome. Yeah, okay. On. Okay. There we go. I'm trying to think. Oh wait, actually that. Oh, wait, go back. Wait. Actually, you'd see all these. Wait, would you see the mountain back here? Okay, actually, yeah, you probably see some mountains back there. So let's do that again. Do. And we're gonna like just kind of do that a little. Need to be kind of like fuzzy a little bit. Again, right, so you're getting a little bit of the Doppler effect and then like water vapor, so that's why it's the colors are going to change slightly as you're going back. Okay, I don't know. Yay! I'll just leave it at that. Like, I know I can keep fidgeting with it. Like, there's a bunch of stuff like this I can keep fidgeting with, but I'm like, this is good enough for the idea of what I want. So I think we're gonna flatten this image. Okay, yeah, we're gonna put this on top of everything. Actually, we need to like squeeze it down. Think it's funny I had to like paint the map to give me an idea of the mountain, then I gotta paint the mountain to give me an idea of the map. Like, hey. Okay, let me see. Okay, there we go. I think that's cool. Okay, this is all gonna be in shadow. Okay. Boom. Oh man, I spent like in 30 minutes, 40 minutes to paint that mountain in order to decide how to do the strokes on this map. Wonderful. Okay, I really need to add tag to the stream self-harm. Okay, so let's sort of meditate on upon this map. I'm always sort of focusing on the geological forces that would shape the map to make it look the way it is, but I really gonna need to be thinking more plot. I really gotta frame this in terms of plot. Okay, so where can I put the death traps? Let's see. So this is where we're gonna have to game out the situation. Okay. So last time our heroes or villains are located here in Oakridge. So either they're gonna travel by road back down, which is possible. Or they're gonna take a boat and go down. Right, well, I mean, it's either the way, they're gonna make their way back. They gotta make their way back down to Klaarg. Okay. Let's see, what can I do to like distract them? Let's put something here. We're gonna put archaeological formations. I don't know. We'll put artifacts right here. And then we'll have to solve the riddle of what they are and what their purpose is. At least 3 sessions. Let's see. I know I put. I think I put that in right there. So I'm trying to think. Okay, so I put the in right there. So they murdered those. They murdered poor murder around here somewhere. So buried her in a shallow grave. Terrible, terrible. And they like. Get my revenge for that one. Okay, let me see. Let me see. So the trick is whether they're gonna go overland. They can go overland. It's possible they can go overland, just straight over the top. Oh, okay. So let's go down to these one by one. Okay, so if they go overland this way, so how can we m murder them here? Okay, so we do have tick monsters. Okay. We put tick monsters there. Actually, there's this interesting idea I'm already working on right there. Okay, so. Okay, so. Let's see, let's put distraction here. Okay. I might put that wolf again here, 'cause there was that wolf that tried to eat Gradol. So, maybe do that, maybe not. Trying to think if I could put another monster right here. Ooh, let's do a leech. A leech is a good idea. A giant leech. Okay. So, What kind of monsters can I put out on the water to eat them? Let's see. We could do a shark. Splash out of the water. Oh, yeah. Let's do a Jaws reference. Let's have a giant shark like bite their boat in half, and then like, oh, we're gonna need a bigger boat. That'll be a good joke. Let's see, what else can we do here? Okay, so let's pull up the continental map. I'm trying to think, okay, so the trick is if they're gonna try to go over land or over the water. Or oh, over land. What is it? One if by land, two if by sea. Okay, so make this interesting. Okay, shark done. Tick monsters, okay. All right, yeah. Kind of want to put another monster on here somewhere. Let's put a monster. We should make up a monster. I don't know, I'm just kind of like doodling. Doodle, doodle, doodle. Actually, that's a good monster I can put right there. Let's do that right now. Let's make a monster. See monsters, see, I don't know what kind of monster it's gonna be. I'll just do claws, bug, something. Come up with a name later. So I kind of like that idea that it has. Okay, well, actually, that's. All right, wait, hold back, hold back, hold back. Okay, think about this. Okay, so we need to make room for, because there's gonna be like one arm here and another arm here and another arm there. Because that's kind of what I want. Okay, we can't quite fit in the canvas, so we're gonna size her down a little. See, my music stopped, so I'm gonna pull up something else. Okay, so let's do a monster now. Monster. Who's a monster? Let's see. Kind of want like twisting appendages, but segmented, so. I want really classic sci-fi, like 50 sci-fi bug monster. With lots of legs. More legs the better. Yeah, I don't think that it's really natural looking for the legs. It looks kind of weird. So like the front and the back are basically gonna be the same. It's gonna be like cat dog. Wait, what's that Pokemon? Yeah, so really like work on the silhouette first. Nice. Yeah, I know, like I think it's a little bit funny the way I'm doing stuff now. Now that I've become more mature as a the person who makes pictures. Like I just kinda like don't care about like the underlying structure. I don't know if I've internalized it a lot or what, but it's just I just don't need to do those weird like skeletons and like under the underlying structure anymore. I just don't. It's just not that interesting to me. Don't care. That's too dark. Yeah, that'll work. Probably should give like a few more segments to it, cause you legs not there or anything. Because arthropods do have quite a bit of segments on their legs. I'm trying to think. I do want an arthropod claw, but I think I want more like a small one. I'm trying to think. Crawdad claw. Crawdad claws, I guess, are more like they are like tiny lobster claws. So is that what I want? Yeah, sure, I guess. Whoops. Right, I'm gonna do like the zigzag here. It's gonna help the creature grip. Grip! Kung Fu grip! Nice. Nice. Doom. No, I'm pretty sure like everyone's like, why is he spoiling it? Well, this is I'm not spoiling it actually. Or rather, the thing is though, I'm making this thing, but you don't know when I'm gonna use it. It's kind of like a shoulder. Do I want a shoulder? Let me see now. I don't know how I'm not exactly sure how symmetrical I want to make this thing, like mouth. Ugh. Trying to think now. Let's try to figure out Yeah, let's look at a crawdad mouth. I really can't. I'm looking at these pictures and I can't tell what is the mouth on this thing. Because they got a lot of moving parts to the dang mouth. Yeah, guys, do not comment. I do not want any comments in the dang chat right now. I know exactly what you're thinking. Needs to be menacing. Huh, I wonder what the bite's gonna be like. Kinda want that jagged mouth to be like, would extend down a little bit further. I'm trying to think of like. I do want them to look like fangs. Yeah, no, I need I want these to look like teeth. I guess they are gonna be teeth, but they're like, See, it's smiling at you. Trying to think, okay, wait. Do 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 do. See, okay, so this stroke right here, that's a mess up, but I like it because it's makes it look freakier. So I can just do things like that on the. So I'll just do like the little spikes there. Just do like a weird claw thingy here. Claw here. Claw here. Claw here. Claw here. Oof. Okay, I'm gonna have to think okay, how do I want to spring this on them? Like a surprise, or do I want them to sort of be thinking about it? Ooh. Oh ho ho. Gonna make this kind of shiny. Shiny and chrome. Hope you're enjoying my little impromptu monster design class here. Cool. Now, okay, so probably should be explaining my thought process here. So it's important to create contrasts, right? So I can't just do the same color the whole way through. So this is a dark. This dark is good enough for the upper part of the body since it's well lit. But as I go further down, right, there's more shadow. This is gonna be shadow, so the blacks have to get blacker. Which reminds me, huh, I should watch that movie. Nice. See. Oh, let me see. Just go a little darker. Probably don't need to be this detailed in it since I'm just kind of doing whatever. Okay, wait, this. So. Interesting thing about arthropods, right? Like their legs kind of start underneath the body and then come up over the top. Okay, see, I gotta change that color now. Nice, okay. I have to redo the leg on the other side to make it match this one, but okay. No, I don't want little missing pixels. Yeah. Let's see now. Cool. Hopefully that gets the idea across. You know what? I kind of did. Well, I guess there's a front. Yeah. I was thinking, like, do I want it perfectly, like, palindromic, front and back? But I guess the back end will be narrower, have more of a tail. And then you can tell by the front because it has, like, the bigger claws in front. Like, the hair thingies on those legs. And I'm gonna put it right there. Hint, hint, wink, wink. Which means I'm not gonna put it there. Ha 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 ha. See. I think, okay, wait, no, that's not done right. You know, I happened to be listening to, like, Smash Mouth earlier. I just happened to be doing it. Like, it feels kind of weird, like, finally being, like, I like where my parents were listening to music that's at this point 30 years old. No, not 30. 24, close enough. I'm just doing that shines a good contrast. Because I don't want to do a black outline the whole way through, which is possible, but it makes everything look flatter. Oh, and the reason why I'm thinking about Smash Mouth now is because I'm listening to a remix of a song from Sixpence None the Richer. No, don't. I. The things don't bend on a hinge exactly like that. There has to be a gap in the middle. I hope this is terrifying enough. I hope it haunts your nightmares. Oops. Kill it with fire. Yeah, I need to put that gap in some of the other ones here. I need a little bit of contrast right here, so contrast, contrast. Oh, it's not wrong. Want the darker one. Okay. I really like it. I like it a lot. Oh, I hope you hate it. So I'm giving a little bit of a zigzag in the claws here. So it allows it to kind of grip, right? So I think it's yeah. Right, so the things don't just slip out. just trying to think if I have them, like, kind of even all the way around. I don't think I have them. Yeah, let's make the top one kind of different than the other ones. I don't need them to be completely symmetric all the way around. Kind of bigger. I want it kind of, I think I want it more even. Okay, so I want this arm to be kind of, oops, in the background slightly, so I do need to like give it maybe a slightly more faded color, take down the saturation just a little bit. Nice. Ah, dang it. Yeah, so like the big broad strokes make this look really flat. So to make it less flat, I need to like add in kind of finer strokes. And like depending on how kind of again, this is where I'm getting into the details, like really into the details. Do like hairs right here, right? Because it's creating more surface area, it's creating more friction, allowing the creature to like grip better. Although I don't think they have it exactly on the claws like I'm doing, but I'm just doing it because just because. So just a few strokes that are kind of like thinner strokes help create contrast, and help distinguish the different components more easily, and so it feels less flat. I still don't have a name for this. Should it be red? Red's a good color, I guess. It's the color of blood. Is that what I want? Maybe. Yeah, like a crawdad from hell. Yeah. A craw demon. There we go. Yeah, I don't know how it's fighting that thing right there. Fighting that claw. Fight the claw. Just trying to create contrast right here, so it'll go darker and darker shades and tones. Yeah, that's too bright here. Like that black should be that black, but that red should not be that red. It should be a darker red. Ooh, ha 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 ha. I just like to stare at the picture for a second, then try to think, okay, well, what am I doing here? What am I doing? You're trying to make the arms a little more symmetrical. I'm trying to think how I'm gonna do these arms. Because I think, okay, so it's tricky here for the perspective. Okay, so like, okay, so yeah, I want that perspective to go like that, so that it's kind of moving directly away from the viewer. See. Yeah, I'm just gonna let that kind of float in the back, not do a lot of color, because it's kind of in the background. I don't want to draw too much attention to that claw. That's why I'm going on a light touch. Hey man, let me do a little bit of a halo here. Just doing this color because I'm trying to get to the contrast with the claw right here, so I want to be able to distinguish between the tail end and that claw. I've been going close to 3 hours this time, so I gotta quit soon. Let me see. Yeah, I gotta make that kind of joint a little bit bigger. Cause right, like bits and pieces of it are too hard, so they're not gonna flex. Okay, shouldn't do that too shiny. I need to make that flatter. I shouldn't put too much shine on that. And I'm just going to kind of do like one color here. So I want this to sort of fade in the background. That's too. I might have to do a darker outline because I need this to come out. I need this to sort of contrast against the rest of the figure dark more. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a dark line that's darker but very fine, so that it contrasts against the rest of the figure, but doesn't flatten the overall image. And then like the face is like super flat compared to the rest of the body, but I guess whatever. Let's give it several rows of teeth. See. Let me see. I kind of want the ridges in the exoskeleton show that it's kind of attached to the teeth. I guess they look more like hairs now, but whatever. Fine. See here. Yeah, I just. See. Can't want to like abandon here somewhere. Again, like I'm doing a lighter, kind of more muted color. Just because like, I want this to fade into the background. Just gonna kind of like, I don't really feel like really making this like really like nice. So I'm just kind of want to make the like make these like feet solid, and then I'll call it a day. Okay. I just want this end already. One layer. One layer, everybody. One layer. I just want more segments because it doesn't. There is. Because remember that they can't. That the outside is hard, and so it doesn't. So unless they have a certain flex point, it will snap, and then they're kind of in trouble. Yeah, okay, no, I need it just completely dark here. Okay, I guess I make the other one fat. This isn't that fat enough. Okay, yeah, just supposed to be the continuation of the leg up there. Okay, let me see. I don't know, like, maybe let's put a little bit of shine, I guess. Okay, let me see. Make sure the foot's kind of bent the right way. I don't think that looks right. I'm trying to look and see if the legs look even. I don't think they look even. I'm missing a segment actually, now that I'm looking at it. Okay, so these two. Okay, so. So this segment matches this segment here. I'm just gonna like cut it and move it forward. So I need a whole other segment like in here. Whole other segment right there. Wait, I'm trying to think how do I want this to look. And maybe not exactly like symmetrical, but close enough, I think. And then well, then it'd be kind of beefy. Oops. Okay. So this other leg is also in a similar situation. I don't think it has as enough segments, actually. See, I need a little bit, okay, so yeah, this is, I'm gonna have to kind of, oops. I'm gonna have to fill in this, because this is gonna be the top of the leg over here. So yeah, trying to get a little bit of contrast in there. Oops. Okay, yeah, okay, right there. I think that's it. Okay, there you go. There's the craw demon. Alrighty. Alright, I'm gonna call it a night. Thank you, everybody. Sweet nightmares.